Hey there! Today we are going to find out how to customize the visibility of fields in a form based on a website visitor's previous answers. It's called branching, and the main idea here is that the answer can send the visitor down different logic paths. Suppose you have a fitness club and you suggest the visitor to fill in a survey to get a personalized offer. If your customer wants to gain muscle, you will offer one set of workouts. And if they want to relax and de-stress, you will offer a different set. As you can see, such customization will help you flexibly ask a person questions, get better answers, and make a suitable personalized offer. Let's see how it works. To make it easier, I made a little diagram with all the questions and branching based on the answer. Let's quickly go through it. Suppose my business is a fitness club. On my website, I ask visitors to fill in a questionnaire so I can make them a personalized offer. First, I ask about a goal they want to achieve by joining our club. It could be losing weight, improving their fitness level, getting muscle mass, or reducing stress. Based on their answer, I will offer them several types of workouts. For example, if the person wants to lose weight, workouts from the first group will be offered. And if reducing stress and improving mood is a priority, workouts from the third group will be suggested. In the next step, I want to recommend several coaches who specialize in the selected area. If a person wants to work out on machines, I suggest trainers with that experience. And if a person wants to dance and stretch, the appropriate instructors will be listed. The next step for all clients will be a question about their current level of physical activity, convenient times to exercise, and desired number of workouts per week. The final step will be a request to leave their contact details so that we can contact them and make a personalized offer. That's what our plan is for today. If you're creating quizzes with branching, I advise you to draw a similar diagram and add the text straight away. The diagram will allow you to visually see the entire communication with the person and avoid logical confusion. Okay, it's time to open Tilda and go to the page editor. First, let me add a block with a step-by-step form to the page. I'll pick block BF919 from the form category. Okay, now I click the Content tab, select the field type Question with Answers, and fill in the title. What is your primary workout goal at the gym? Then I add answer options: weight loss, improve general fitness, strength and muscle gain, and stress relief and mood enhancement. And I'll slightly twist the style of the answer choices display. Moving on to the next question. Let me remind you that the content of this field depends on the answer in the previous one. Now I want the person who has chosen to lose weight and improve their overall fitness to see certain workouts. To do this, I go to the second field, select the type Question with Image Answers, and add the text and images that I have prepared in advance. Then, at the bottom of the card, I click More and customize the conditions under which this card becomes visible. I want this field to be displayed under two conditions. First, if in the field 1 the person has selected the answer weight loss. And second, the answer about improving fitness was also selected. Right. Now let's set up another field for those who want to gain muscles. I duplicate the second card and replace the contents. Then I need to change the display conditions. I want this field to appear only for those who selected strength and muscle gain answer in the first question. I don't need the second condition, so I'll remove it. In a similar way, I'll fill in the next field. It will appear if the person selected stress relief as their fitness goal in the first question. Note that I only customize the visibility conditions for the second and following steps. It is impossible to customize visibility for the first step, as it is always displayed to a person. The show or hide conditions will be different depending on the field type you choose as a condition. For example, for single or multiple line input fields, we can fully compare the value, check if the content matches partially, if it contains a certain value, or if the field is filled or left empty. For fields like checkbox or file, we can condition the field display based on whether the checkbox is selected and if any file is uploaded. For numeric values, you can check if the number is within a given range, is greater than or less than a certain value, and so on. Right, to finalize my survey, I need to create and set up a few more fields. Let me do this quickly, just like I did for the previous fields. Okay, and here is what the survey looks like. Workout recommendations depend on the overall goal, and the choice of coach expertise depends on the kind of workout preferred by the visitor. If you want to take this very survey yourself, find the link to it in the description under the video. The ability to branch questions based on answers is available in all vertical and step-by-step forms, as well as in the shopping cart. A link to the detailed guide to setting visibility conditions for each field is also in the video description. Thanks for watching this tutorial. See you soon. Bye-bye.